Some good news. Emi Buendia is back in team training since Wednesday, so he's available. Also, Todd Cantwell also since Wednesday back in team training available. Ibrahim Amadou since Tuesday, so one day before also available. So in general, some good news.
So you think those three have a good chance of playing a part?
Well, we will have some late decisions. That's for sure. And one thing is for sure, I won't play all three of them because it's anyhow important game, and also it will be definitely an intense game. And I think you can't start a game when you start a game on this level, away game, when with three players who were injured recently. So it's more like it's up to us to have a late decision really who is really fully prepared, because it's a bit tricky really to start with too many injured players just because they're back in team training. But at least it's good to have them back, and they will have good chances to be in the traveling squad.
Signed a player this morning, Sam McCollum from Coventry, going back there on loan, but nonetheless, what can you tell us about him?
Well, in general, so I spoke about our whole strategy. One topic, and the most important topic, especially for me, and of course, is to be focused on the short-term success with the first team. And for that, we tried to bring some players in, and brought Lukas Rupp and Andre Duda in, have proved already that they can be quite important. The other topic is then to work also like on the mid on the long term for the future of our club. And in this terms, we are always searching for some good options, some young options. So our way is to develop young players, and in this terms, Sam is fantastic. So he's done a really, really good job at Coventry so far, and he's young, left fullback, also not that easy to find, full of potential, great character, and good homegrown, good part of business for us also in the mid and long term. It's a bit. I'm not so tempted to speak so much about the strength or perhaps about the topics where he has to improve. So we see there's lots of potential in him, and we'll open the door and give him all the tools, and then it's up to him how far he can come. And it's a bit too far away to predict how important he can be in the future. But it's definitely a good signing, and I think definitely also a proof of our way.
Deadline day today, 11 o'clock this evening. Can you bring us up to date with any possible deals that Norwich might be involved in today, or have you, do you think you've done everything for now?
No, Sally, I have to disappoint you also. Nothing in the pocket, and I don't think that there will happen anything. So for us, nothing will happen. That's definitely for sure. And I don't. You never know in the last hours if there's any crazy offer or something like this. But I don't expect this, and no one has knocked on my door today. At least till 5 minutes ago, no one has knocked on Stuart's door. I'm not sure what happened in the last 5 minutes, but all I can say so far, don't expect any business.
Man United have been linked with lots of players today. In the last hour, Timo Pukki has been mentioned in the media. Is there any chance at all that anything could happen there? You talked about crazy offers, for example.
Yes, but we have rejected the £100 million offer, so for that, no chance.
Wow.
No, in general, so we are we spoke about our situation as a club. We are not in the position to buy many players at least on a special level, because we can't spend that much money. But we have a much better situation in terms of we don't have to sell any player. And one thing is for sure, all the players that are important for us, we won't sell any player. And that's a big improvement in comparison to all the other last transfer windows, because we had to sell some of our best players in order to keep this club going. And really, all jokes aside, so there could be any offer for any of our players that we need right now. We won't sell any of our players right now. So it's of course, and perhaps a different situation in the summer, but not right now. So we need all the players in order to work on our little miracle, and we can't go for the one without Timo Pukki or without all the other lads. So for that, no chance.
So looking at the whole month, I mean, you've been quite busy. You've brought in four players, I think six, maybe seven, and going out in most of them loans. I mean, how difficult has it been competing against teams in this division with such huge budgets, actually?
Yes, it is difficult without any doubt, and you have to try to be a bit quicker and a bit more creative, and you always have a bigger guarantee if you can sign a player who is fully in his rhythm and knows the league and something like this. But in order to do this, to get such a player, you have to spend unbelievable amount of money, and that's what we can't do. And for that, we have to be a bit more creative. And I'm pleased with this window without any doubt, because in general, we allowed a few fringe players or players who are not so much involved to to leave, and also a few loans. We brought in two really proper first team players with Andre Duda and Lukas Rupp, and I think they have proved already that they can help us soon, immediately. Andre as a loan, and also Lukas with a permanent signing. I think definitely a really, really good part of business. Many compliments to Stuart that we were able to bring this quality players in. And yeah, also a bit piece of business in terms of for the future with some young players, with players lots of potential again. So how valuable they will be, so we have to wait a bit how the future will develop. But I think also like in this term, so also like a good from the business point of view, and also like from a proof of our way to we want to work with young players and want to improve them. And it's also a good sign that this players there were also lots of interests on Sam, for example, or on Melvin, that they were willing really to sign for us. And yeah, I'm pleased with all the business, to be honest.